To be in service, because if you think about it, we're not really worthy to even be alive and breathe his breath, but he breathes in our direction, and that's from where all blessings come. And that's why we praise him. That's why we gather. That's why we worship. Amen. On Happy Sunday. It's not just a Sunday, it's Happy Sunday. It's not just service, it's God's service. It's not just secular labor, it's the labor of the kingdom of God. Come on, somebody. Now, there's a difference. There's a difference in service. There's a difference in labor. There's a difference in government, and there's a difference in God's. There's a separation. He said, come out from among the world. Be ye separate, said the Lord. Touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you. Thank God this morning for the reception of the saints. Amen. That he died on Mount Calvary so that we can be set free, set all the captives free. Amen. Miss Diane, can you play a few songs we haven't heard in a while? It doesn't matter what book, just a few songs. Amen. Lead us and ask God to anoint and bless and guide. Help us in today's service. We invite God into our hearts and hope.
Start off with 368.
Jesus, oh, precious is the
Let's get 184.
Thank you.
Churches and all the believers in the body of Christ. We're praying for all souls to come to know Jesus as we know Jesus. You want to know how to fill the house of God up? Tell somebody about Jesus Christ. Amen. They might not come here, but they're going to go somewhere. And hey, that's a seed and a soul to the Lord for the kingdom of God. Amen. But I'm here to tell you, there is a tilling and a shaking around here. There's groundbreaking around here. You know, we had a record high last Sunday in tithes and offerings, amen, a record high, $718. Give God some praise. Give God some praise. Hallelujah. $718. There was only three or four people here giving. But I tell you, we sowed mighty in the name of Jesus. Don't let this Sunday be a normal Sunday and sow low. You hear me? Don't sow low. Don't backtrack on God and don't give up. Keep going. Keep plowing. Keep tilling in the name of Jesus. If you do that, God will bless you. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's take a look at Worldwide Vision Day.
I've got peace like a river in my soul. I've got love like an ocean. Thank you.
Salvation in the name of Jesus. Healing of the blind. Can he do it? Hallelujah. Can he heal the blind? In the name of Jesus. Write it in chat. Jesus, heal the blind. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In the name of Jesus, save the lost. In the name of Jesus. Jason Williams, thank you so much for touching and agreeing with me that God can still heal the blind and work miracles and save the lost. Amen. At this time, receive glory to God. Minister Ted, this one is going to lead us in the Sunday school hour. Amen. Receive it.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Glad to see you here today. And we're going to be reading in Exodus chapter 7. And the Lord said unto Moses, see, I have made thee a god to Pharaoh, and Aaron thy brother shall be thy prophet. Thou shalt speak all that I command thee, and Aaron thy brother shall speak unto Pharaoh that he send the children of Israel out of his land. And I will harden Pharaoh's heart and multiply my signs and wonders in the land of Egypt. But Pharaoh shall not hearken unto you that I may lay my hand upon Egypt and bring forth my armies and my people, the children of Israel, out of the land of Egypt by great judgments. And the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I stretch forth my hand upon Egypt and bring out the children of Israel from among them. And Moses and Aaron did as the Lord commanded them. So did they. And Moses was fourscore and three years old when they spake unto Pharaoh. And the Lord spake unto Moses and unto Aaron, saying, When Pharaoh shall speak unto you, saying, show a miracle for you, then thou shalt say unto Aaron, take thy rod and cast it before Pharaoh, and it shall become a serpent. And Moses and Aaron went unto Pharaoh, and they did so as the Lord had commanded. And Aaron cast down his rod before Pharaoh and before his servants, and it became a serpent. Then Pharaoh also called the wise men and the sorcerers and the magicians of Egypt, and they also did like them with their enchantments. For they cast down every man his rod, and they became serpents. But Aaron's rod swallowed up their serpent, their rods. And he hearkened Pharaoh's heart that he hearkened not unto them as the Lord had said. And the Lord said unto Moses, Pharaoh's heart hardened and refused to let the people go. Go thee unto Pharaoh in the morning. Lo, he goeth out unto the water, and thou shalt stand by the river brink. Against he come, and the rod which was turned to a serpent, shall thou take it thine hand. And thou shalt say unto him, thy Lord God of the Hebrews has sent me unto thee, saying, let my people go, that they may serve me in the wilderness. And behold, hitherto thou wast thou not here. And saith the Lord, thus saith the Lord, in this thou shalt know that I am the Lord. Behold, I will smite, and the rod that is in my hand upon the waters which are in the river, and they shall turn to blood.
Jesus.
And the fish that is in the river shall die, and the river shall stink, and the Egyptians shall loathe to drink of the water of the river. And the Lord spake unto Moses, say unto Aaron, take thy rod and stretch out thy hand upon the water of Egypt unto the streams upon their rivers and upon their ponds and upon all their pools, and the water that they may become blood, and that they may be blood throughout all the land of Egypt, both in vessels of wood and in vessels of stone. And Moses and Aaron did so as the Lord commanded, and he lifted up the rod and smote the waters that were in the river in the night, and Pharaoh and in the sight of his servant, and all the waters that were in the river were turned to blood. And the fish that was in the river died, and the river stank. The Egyptians could not drink of the water of the river, and there was blood throughout all the land of Egypt. And the magicians of Egypt did so with their enchantments, and Pharaoh's heart was hardened. Neither did he hearken unto them, as the Lord had said.
Yes.
And Pharaoh turned and went into his house. Neither did he set his heart to this also. And all the Egyptians digged around about the river for water to drink. For they could not drink of the water of the river. And 7 days were fulfilled. After that, the Lord had smitten the river.
Hallelujah. Now, what's that say to you? What's that chapter say to you?
That chapter's telling me that if you don't do what the Lord has told you to do, that he would get what he wanted from you, even if he had turned everything into blood to get your attention.
In the name of Jesus.
He would get your attention.
Yes, yes.
And you will do what the Lord God has commanded you to do.
You got it.
One way or the other.
Hallelujah.
And be it rather be the easy way.
Come on.
Or it can be the hard way. It's going to be the Lord's way.
Yes.
Either way.
Hallelujah.
It's not going to be your way. It's not going to be my way. It's not going to be Pharaoh's way.
Hallelujah.
It's going to be the Lord's way.
Yeah.
The Lord will have his way.
Yes.
No matter what.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Give God some praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Bless you so much.
Mighty word from God. Amen. In Exodus 7 and 9, we see the prophecy. You see the prophecy before something happens, God tells us that it's going to happen. John 13:19. In Exodus 7 and 10, there's a quick prophecy fulfillment. Quick. You dare say amen.
Amen.
Some prophecies take years, thousands of years, but this was instant. Amen. And then in Exodus 7 and 12, you see false prophets. After the prophecy is fulfilled, you start to see false prophets. Come on, somebody. After God has spoken, then that attracts all other things into the revival. You there say amen. Come on, somebody. And then in Exodus 7:13, they were leaving God. They fell farther from God than they were from the beginning. It is best that a false prophet stay far away from a true prophet of the Lord, lest they worsen off than they were in the beginning. You there say amen. God has given up examples. He's raised up examples. The blood can be for you or it will be against you. Either way, as you heard the minister say, God is going to have his way. Let God have his way in today's service and in your life. Receive it right now in the mightiest, matchless, maximum name of Jesus. Give him some praise in the house of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Every time God speaks and he tells his servants, go and say, go command them, go tell them. A lot of people don't like that word command, but if you're in the army, he commands. And he has 10 main commandments, but that's not the only commandments. Every word of God is a commandment.
That's right.
There, say amen. Hallelujah, glory to God. So when he commands, when he prophesies and tells them, tell my people, and then all of a sudden you start seeing all this gathering of false prophets. I would to God that the seeds that were sown would sprout up and we can have a harvest, not of false prophets, but true prophets in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
My God. Every time a prophecy is fulfilled, you see all the false comes. Just like it says in Matthew 24, in the last days it would happen. But it didn't just happen in the last days. That's an increase. Somebody say increase.
Increase.
Increase of false prophets and false prophecies that want attention on self and not on Jesus. Moses pointed to God, the great I am. And even in the beginning of times, you see Exodus, there were false prophets. And the Bible says in the last days, as Jannes and Jambres withstood Moses, these will also withstand you and your words.
Amen.
That's the Bible. Say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Are there any other testimonials, lessons, teachings, conclusions to the matter?
Well, I think it's interesting to note that in several places it says that the Lord hardened Pharaoh's heart. There's times when it was the Lord hardened his heart for his own purpose, to demonstrate his power and his capability.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then there were times that it was on Pharaoh.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's a man, he's in a way.
Mm-hmm.
He thinks, I'm Pharaoh, I'm this, I'm that, I'm the other. And he doesn't realize that he has no power unless God, it comes from God.
Thank you. There's something worse than being in the flesh. Even Christian can get in the flesh and not in the spirit. If you prophesy in the flesh, it's going to... Okay, so there's something called high-mindedness. High-mindedness is the worst kind of person on the land. And let me tell you why I say that. A high mind is a know-it-all, and they're higher than God's ways. He says, lean not to your own understanding, and all your ways acknowledge me, and I will direct your path. If you're high-minded, you're already directing your own path. There's no room for Jesus. He must increase, and I must decrease. He resists the proud and giveth grace to the humble. So, get rid of high-mindedness, humble yourself, harden not your heart, receive the word of God, and you will watch increase in your life. Not increase of high-mindedness, but increase of the power of Almighty God. Does that make sense? There's so many people that have a lot of money. They have a lot of false science, falsely so-called. You dare say amen. But there's a true science. Don't do away with science. Because true science approves of God. It actually tells you that there's a God. But science, falsely so-called, and secular government and secular labor and job, there's a separation there, so you got to be careful. I'm not saying do away with all of it. I'm saying be careful to not be high-minded in the world. The governments of the world, Pharaoh was a king, a president. You got to be careful to not be caught up in high-mindedness. As a matter of fact, thank you, Holy Ghost. God has said that the world is trying to come into the church of Laodicea. And he rebuked the worldliness of Laodicea. They got too carried away. They got too caught up in that instead of that. The Holy Ghost. You there? Now watch me. God has said in times past that there will be a second civil war. And the precursor was, what was that? They had spray painted the ground and called it a different name. They took over the city. Does anybody remember? But anyway, that was a precursor to the coming civil war. There is, believe it or not, high-mindedness in political-only Christians. Political-only Christians, meaning man will save me, Donald Trump. You've got to be careful with that because man will always fail you in the flesh. Even if a Christian get in the flesh, it can fail. And of course, the world is going to fail you in the flesh when they have not the proofs and the spirit and the fruits of God. I said all that to say this. Be mindful and careful what comes into the church. If it's the world, the Lord rebuke it. If it's God, he receive it.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. And the civil war is in the spirit. We war in the spirit. We wrestle not against flesh and blood. We wrestle not against flesh and blood. So God is saying the coming civil war starts in the house of God to war in the spirit against the principalities. Spiritual wickedness in high places. That's what Moses did with Pharaoh. Before they ever battled with swords and claimed swords physical, there was a spiritual battle right there. You saw it when he threw down the rod. That was spiritual. There's a spiritual rod we throw down today in the name of Jesus right now. You there? So we're warring in the spirit against all the false prophets and false prophecies to say, you know, our ways are going to work and, you know, not the ways of the word of God, such as Psalm 91, it shall not come nigh thee, or Mark chapter 16, you lay hands on the sick and they recover. That's not going to be the way. We're going to be the way. We're going to be high-minded. We're trying to discredit and do away with God. Be careful and mindful of those things. We need deliverance from that in the name of Jesus. And I'm going to tell you something else. I'm going to tell you something else we need deliverance from. You ready? If a man has had a part in a woman aborting the baby, the man needs deliverance unknowingly. Because it's a pain and a hurt spiritually that you do not know of. That's a murder of a life. Does everybody agree with that? Even the woman specifically to the body, the physical to the body needs deliverance, and the spiritual needs deliverance as well. I'm not saying it can't be forgiven. It's the unpardonable sin. I said, don't do it in Jesus' name. If you're thinking about doing it, don't do it. For it is written, God hates hands that shed innocent blood. The blood of Jesus will be against you if you shed innocent blood. You must get deliverance. You must come to the altar. You must receive prayer in the maximum name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So the coming civil war that's trying to be about politics, the Republicans against the Democrats, the coming civil war, one against another, God rebuke it. God's not in it. You want to know what he's in? You want to know where his government's at? Right here. You want to know who's King of Kings and Lord of Lords? You want to know who the president is? You want to know where the government's at? Preacher, I don't understand what you're saying. Let me tell you what I'm saying. God gave Moses, not Pharaoh. God gave Samuel, not Saul. The people wanted a king. God gave them a king, but it was not the king that he had chose. The king was supposed to be the high priest known as the Levite Samuel, who was also a judge. The prophet is supposed to be the king. Thank God for King David, who was also a king and a prophet. Give God some praise in the house of God. You want to know who else was also a king and a prophet? Jesus Christ, the lineage of David that come from the root of Jesse. Give God some praise. Come on. Hallelujah. Glory to God, the government of God. Hallelujah. People don't follow. They don't understand. Amen. You can follow the world and high-mindedness in the government of the world, and it's going to lead you to hell.
That's right.
But if you follow God, he'll lead you to heaven.
Amen.
You got to be careful. You got to be mindful of the truth. The truth will set you free. It will make you free. And whoever the Son of Man sets free is free indeed. Is anybody free in the house of God? Anybody free in the house of God? Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody might say, Donald Trump can save me from my sins. The devil is a liar. Somebody might say, the Pope can save me from my sin. The devil is a liar. But if I preach Jesus to you, he's all in all. Author and finisher of our faith. If I give you Jesus, I love you. And I have seen this church grow and mature. Sure, people have departed. People don't like what's happening out here. People want it normal, but I've tried to be normal. I'm telling you, I cannot be normal. I've seen growth. I've seen spiritual growth. I've seen the power of God move in this church and in your lives. I've seen growing. I've seen people get closer to God. Hallelujah. People's learning about God more and more. The truth of it, not just a half truth and a whole and a half lie, make a whole lie. I want all. God wants all to learn of these things. God wants all to know that he's coming soon. That he's ultimate. That he's first. It says, seek first the kingdom of God. Don't seek first Washington. What are you doing? That's an error. We're not 144,000. What's wrong with you? Come on. His throne shall be in Israel. When the third and final temple is built, the Antichrist will go in there and sit and call himself God. But guess what's going to happen? God is going to come back and say, get down off my throne and take his rightful place in the name of Jesus. Every knee will bow, every tongue will confess. You, me, the atheist, Donald Trump, everybody. And listen, I'd rather have Donald Trump than Joe Biden, don't get me wrong. But Donald preaching Donald Trump cannot save somebody's soul from hell.
That's right.
It can't. Let's be honest. Our gas prices were wonderful up under Donald Trump. Joe Biden has the worst gas prices I've ever seen my whole life. But I'm telling you, preaching Joe Biden does nothing. Preaching Donald Trump does nothing for the soul and the spirit. It might do something for your bank account, but it does nothing for the heart and soul of man. You there say amen. I don't wanna be mean, but I do want to be real and I want to be truthful. Hallelujah. And then there's this thing. It's the second part to the political. The political is not the only error in the church. The other thing is looking at flesh. Watch me now. I was in a convention yesterday and I had a meeting I went to, and God help this elderly brother. I stood up and I said, you know, there are three men that came off from Noah's lineage. Shem, Ham, and Japheth. Three. You only hear talk about two. Can I say it? Can I be frank with you? The black and the white. Where's the middle? Where's the medium? Where's the brown man? Gets left out. And I believe it pricked this man's heart. He stood up and said, well, it had to mean something to God because God made black and white. You still mentioned it. You didn't mention the brown again. You're still leaving them out. You're missing the point. Three families came off the ark. All. Somebody say all. Come off the ark and from Noah. Not just two. Stop that in the name of Jesus. That has come into the church for far too long. The Lord rebuke it in Jesus' name. Shem, Ham, and Japheth. Hallelujah. One up north where it gets cold and, you know, he had lighter skin because there's no sun shining. And one in the middle, in the midst, the brown. You there say amen. It gets a little warm. And then it gets real hot down south. You know, you go down Florida, it gets hotter and hotter. You go up north, it gets a little cooler. When it snows in the middle of North Carolina, we don't know what to do. We don't know how to handle it. It hardly snows at all in Florida. And it snows all the time in up north. The point is, all that junk is carnality. It's division. Beware of Satan's devices. God made all and all come from Noah, and then you could trace it all the way back, and God all came from Adam for the same reason that God made different kinds of trees, because he's not boring. And somebody might say, he made all kind of dogs. He didn't make all kind of dogs. He made one dog. It's called a dog. He made one race. It's called a human race. Give him some praise in the house of God. Amen. Two got on the ark. Two. And from that come all dogs, even wolves, sadly. I'm talking spiritual wolves. Real wolves are beautiful. They're beautiful. Hallelujah. I believe that's enough revelation for now. God's rebuking carnality coming into the church. He's rebuking strife, unforgiveness. He's rebuking jealousy. You know, there was a man that gave sacrifice better than another. There were two brothers. Anybody remember? Cain and Abel. You got it. And Abel gave a more excellent sacrifice. And Cain was a bigot. He did not like it. Got jealous with him. His own brother. And he killed him. We can't have civil war in the church. We can't have Cain and Abel spirits in the church. We must have Abel, ready, willing, and able spirit. We can't have Cain. The Lord rebuke it. That's the final time. Amen. Let's move on. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. God came and died for all. Operator. Operator, come on. Jesus gave his life for every nation, every tongue, every kindred, every tribe. Amen. Mother, can you dismiss Sunday school?
This privilege we have together, no man to worship in spirit and truth, to study your word, to pray God to give us of your truth and greater understanding, and draw closer to you. Put us one another for the Bible that we may study the world, Lord, to present the gospel to the lost and dying generation. Help us, Lord, ever be what you have us to be. Bless the church, have the grown spirit in your mind.
Amen. Amen. We also want to greet everybody here, the Mount Moriah's own, those watching by YouTube, TikTok. If my son and hallelujah, Kenya is watching, spiritual son, we salute you and greet you. Pastor Joshua, we love you. We love you all the leaders, all the laborers. Amen. Let's praise the Lord.
Thank you. At the end of the line, with all the other not quite. We all will never get it right. But turns out there's a tune for all this time. I'm just a young boy. I'm just a
God, a tithe offering this morning or donation, you could bring it forth at this time by faith, amen, in the Lord, giving from your heart to God's heart in this, hallelujah, outpouring and revival, Acts chapter 2 movement in the last days, Latter-day Rain, bless you all so much for giving from the heart to the heart of God. It is God's will that we continue in daily revival. People love to, hallelujah, talk about the Sabbath being on Saturday, and the Pope changed it in the Gregorian calendar, and they get into all these genealogies that the Lord said, do not do, that receive his rest, which is the Sabbath. That he is every day. He said that I add to the church daily as I see fit, not just on the Sabbath. It's a mess. It's a mess. The Lord rebuke religion and high-mindedness in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I don't just worship God on Saturday. I don't just worship God on Sunday. You know, there's a midweek Sabbath too. Did you know that? If you look it up, you can find it in the Bible. There's a midweek Sabbath. Receive it. Believe it right now. Hallelujah. They don't know. They don't know. They don't know everything. They know a little bit of something, and they're taking and run with it. It's a mess. The Holy Ghost leads. If the Holy Ghost lead, ain't leading, it ain't nothing.
That's right.
It's religion, high-mindedness, bunch of junk. Amen. If you have your Bibles, will you please turn with me to Revelation 14 and 4. Revelation 14 and 4. Praise God. Hallelujah. Please sow into this move of God and revival as God lays it on your heart. Ask God for the more. Amen. Give a little more and watch God give a lot more. Hallelujah. Talk to God about giving $5 extra. Can you do $5 extra a month, a week, a day? Can, hallelujah, can you, yes, can you do 10 extra? Talk to God. Pray to God about it. Amen. There's some big things coming. There's some revivals coming. There's some conventions coming. Amen. And God knows the needs. He'll meet every need. Revelation 14, chapter, verse 4. Can you please stand for the reading of God's holy word? Amen. The followers of the Lamb, the fall of Babylon, etc., etc. These are they which were not defiled with women, for they are virgins. These are they which follow the Lamb whithersoever he goeth. These were redeemed from among men, being the first fruits unto God and to the Lamb. The first fruits unto God and to the Lamb. You may be seated. Most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, I pray over this word that it's not my word, it's your word. Lord, move in this place, touch hearts, touch lives, set the captives free. Lord, deliver, O God, those that unknowingly, hallelujah, might need a touch. Hallelujah, be it gainsaying, usurping, hindrance, lying spirit, whatever it is, Lord. Touch, reveal, anoint, redeem, hallelujah, strengthen. Lord, we praise you in this place that we can talk about Moses, that we can talk about David, that we can talk about the 12, and the song that plays before the sermon that's preached talks about each and every one of them. And God, I thank you for confirmation, just a little confirmation. Father, as we're disciples of you, allow us to be also disciples of revival. And not just revival and survival, but world revival. I give you praise. I give you thanks. I bless your holy name. Lamb of God, Son of God, God the Father, Holy Ghost, touch. Oh, turn it around, God, for your glory and purpose, using your disciples worldwide. In Jesus' name I pray. We love you. We give you praise. Let everybody say together in chat and in the church, amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah. God calls this disciples of the Lord. Or somebody might say disciple of revival. Hallelujah. Revelation 14 and 4. These are they. Are you one of they which were not defiled with women, for they are virgins? These are they which follow the Lamb whithersoever he goeth. Hallelujah. We have to follow the Lord and the Lamb whithersoever he goeth. These were redeemed from among men, being first fruits unto God and to the Lamb. He's talking about first fruits being the church. The Bible tells me that he came unto his own, and his own received him not. He tells us now, all whosoever will, I have made you the head and no longer the tail. That means first fruits. Amen, somebody. Father the Lamb,
He purifies these. The first unto God and to the Lamb. You see a separation there from God and unto the Lamb. Following the Lamb purifies and it redeems the church, the saved, the heavenly. Ephesians 5:27, that he might present it to himself, a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. Are you holy and without blemish this morning? Are you blood washed? Are you blood bought? Do you try to live holy? Do you try to live righteous? Are you a disciple of the Lord Jesus this morning? These have restrained from flesh practices and worldly behaviors. And listen, I can rebuke easily and fault find at least one thing in every church that I've ever been in beside, because people are carnal or just plain flesh. But I'm here to tell you the Spirit of God preserves us, the blood washing us. Amen. We ought to see good things as disciples of the Lord. Amen. I know how it's like to be a leader, to upkeep. I know the rest is that. But we also have others that have to come inside and be redeemed and set free. Amen. I know that. I understand. Hallelujah. We have to receive the rest. Somebody say rest. Rest from the Lord. Amen. I've never been to a church that I didn't see a fault in. Never. Not one. You want to know why? Because all have fallen short of the glory of God. But if you be Jesus, if you be belong to him, guess what? We are all redeemed. We're all washed. We're all blood bought. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And I'm here to tell you, glory to God, he puts them up high and he puts them down low. He puts the high-minded in their place down low and he puts the lowly up high. Can I get amen? Can I get an amen in the house of God? And am I talking to anybody? I'm nobody. I'm nothing. But God, hallelujah, has raised me up to speak on his behalf. Hallelujah. I was a sinner. I was a murderer at heart. I was a drug user, an alcoholic, a drug dealer, and all those sorts of things. And I could keep going on and on and on about all I used to be. And I'm not proud about that. But I'm proud of it today to know Jesus Christ has redeemed me from all that junk, all that hogwash, all that worldliness. Yet I'm a disciple of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. The Bible says that, hallelujah, the humble are greatest. Watch me now. Love is the greatest. The pure at heart are greatest. Children are the greatest. Hallelujah. Children of God are the greatest. So let's get off the church competition. God rebukes it. Hallelujah. All churches are rebuked except the Church of Philadelphia. Brotherly love. You want to know why God rebukes all the other churches, the worldly church, the lukewarm church, the church of competition, the church of pride, the church of money? You want to know why God rebukes it all? Because they're missing the mark when not having love. Without love, they're not of God. But to have love is to receive a brother or sister. To have love, amen, love covers a multitude of sins. Is that what the Bible says? Hallelujah. We could go tit for tat, and that's what Satan wants us to do, to go back and forth arguing with one another about who's the best church or who's the best preacher. But I'm here to tell you, once again, all have fallen short of the glory of God. You want to know who the best preacher is? You want to know who the best, you said it. You want to know who the best pastor is, the prophet is, the best apostle is? I tell you, it's Jesus Christ and him crucified. Amen. A man that would lay down his life for his friends, that's greatest. And God sees that sacrifice. God sees daily revival in your heart. God sees, hallelujah, ultimately the blood of Jesus applied. Yeah, we are disciples of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. A follower of Jesus. Amen. We go wheresoever he tells us. Wheresoever the Spirit is moving. Wherever there's revival. Wherever there's healing and miracles. Wherever there's signs and wonders. Because we know that he is author and finisher of our faith. By the way, Satan, I rebuke you. I plead the blood.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I tried having a normal service, just being a normal. They say I'm just a normal preacher. I'm just a normal. This is just a normal church. And those that are normal wants it normal. And those that are high-minded say, hallelujah, that it is normal. And those that are worldly-minded say that they want it normal. You can't please people. You can't please nobody. But thank God I'm a disciple of the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm here to please the Lord. I come to please Jesus. Give him some praise in the house of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Watch me now. You got to be careful with this next one. Hallelujah. Challenging church and position stops today. Challenging the church and being opposing the church, the Lord rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Challenging positions that God has raised up a Moses stops today. Whoever that Moses is, whoever Elijah is, let God have his way, or the blood will be against you. The blood will be on your hands. Either it's for you or against you. Hallelujah. And the first lady is to also be treated with respect. Hallelujah. You know what happens if I'm not treated with respect? Conviction of the Holy Ghost, and I'm going to plead the blood. You already know. We're disciples of the Lord. God wants spotless followers, cleansed and blood washed, no guile, no fault, holy and righteous. Watch it. Matthew 4:18-20. And Jesus walking by the Sea of Galilee. Somebody say, Jesus walking. Saw two brethren, Simon called Peter and Andrew, his brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishers. But how many know that they were fishing for the wrong thing? Amen. I'm not telling you to quit your secular job. I'm not telling you that. Don't believe that I'm saying that. But I'm saying more important than secular work is the labor of the Lord, being a disciple of the Lord. Can I get an amen? And he saith unto them, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. How many know if you follow the Lord, your job will be better? Your pay will be better. There will be increase in your house. But you got to pay your tithes. It's in there. And they straightway left their nets and followed him. They left the boat. They left the fishing rod. They left the hooks. They left the net. They even left their daddy. And follow Jesus. And their daddy like, where are my sons at? Man, we got to get this work done. Where'd they go? I'm telling you, when the power of God touch you, you'll never be the same again. You'll put down everything in Jesus' name. I don't care if it's tobacco. I don't care if it's cocaine. I don't care if it's beer. I don't care if it's whiskey or moonshine, Percocet, Lord set. God is greatest than all. Give him some praise in the house of God. Hallelujah. Because how he fished them. Hallelujah. They now go and fish for others. Did you hear what I said? How he fished for them. You now go and fish for others because you have been fished. You're in the pond. Come and bring them in the pond. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Phone call others. You ever notice whenever the phone starts ringing, boy, it really starts ringing. You ever notice that? It's a busy time when somebody calls somebody and calls somebody else and just start. That's because when God gets to moving, he really gets to move. He's using you. Hallelujah. Call them to what? Call them to repentance. From what? The world. Ultimately from hell. Amen. Disciples of the Lord. The Spirit of God can discern the need for another human being, especially another believer. Watch it now. Never look down on somebody unless you're helping them up the mountain of Moriah. Give them some praise in the house of God. Amen. God didn't call us to kick anyone off the mountain. Amen. This isn't King of the Mountain. And if it's needed, hallelujah, we need to be reminded who the King of Kings and Lord of Lords is. He sits up high and he looks down up. That's how you test the Spirit. Spirit. The many only hear one shepherd, who is Jesus. Hallelujah. The shepherd has many under shepherds. Can I get an amen? Hallelujah. Say amen. And rejecting them is rejecting him in the Holy Ghost church. Hallelujah. Isaiah 42 and 3. A bruised reed shall he not break, and smoking flax shall he not quench. He shall bring forth judgment unto truth, disciples of the Lord. So we see he discerns. If he sees you bend, he's not going to break you. If he sees you bent over, hunched over, he's not going to finish you off. What's he going to do? He's going to lift you up. You got to lift up holy hands. You got to lift the hands that hang down. The Bible tells you to exhort your brethren. I mean, don't judge them and put them down all the time. Every time they come around you, you want to throw them down that you're better than them. You're better than nobody. Only God is greatest. Amen. And the greatest in the kingdom of God are those that humble themselves as a little child. Give them some praise in the house of God. Hallelujah. Every time revival happens, every time we go into the community, then come all the false prophets, all the false prophecies, all the discord. I'm tired of the little rebuke. God wants increase in his house. God wants his house filled. If it's not going to be filled with people, it's going to be filled with rocks. If it's not going to be filled with people, it's going to be filled with rocks. I'm going to start putting rocks on the benches out here. In the name of Jesus, the rocks will cry out. If the people won't come in, the rocks will be here. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So we see he discerns. He sees you've been over, he won't break you. Nor will he quench the smoke and the fire of the great Holy Ghost. Amen. How many know if there's a smoke, there's a fire? If someone is about to lose their loved one, or someone who has lost a loved one, what do you think he will do? Rebuke them? You think he's going to kick them down? If somebody's gone blind, will he spit on them and slap them across the face? Or will he pray for them? So we see some strange acts. Somebody say strange acts. Not acts of God. Not acts of discipleship. You got to discern correctly, or you discern wrong. In a season where it seems like someone's almighty and powerful, they're still going through something. They're still going through something. I don't care the mightiest preacher on the planet. Still going through something. And you don't know. And you come and they've been over in the spirit. You don't know it. All you see them standing up high. And then you start rebuking them. The Lord rebuke you in the name of Jesus. If someone is about to lose their loved one, God will comfort them. He said, comfort ye my people. Comfort ye my people. Is that what the Lord says? Hallelujah. Come with rebukes. These preachers rebuking everything all the time in their might in someone's season of troubles. It's out of touch. It's out of touch to rebuke somebody in a funeral. To preach somebody into hell. You don't have a hell to put them in. Right. Nor do you have a heaven to put them in. You better just preach the Bible, because the blood's going to be against you. Right. And the blood's going to be on your hand. I'm warning you in the name of Jesus. Right. All the preachers. Every one of you. Go ahead and rebuke. You get rebuked right back. Hallelujah. It's just out of touch. Based on this scripture, it's not so. Unless the grieving is over a deliverance that is needed, leave them alone in Jesus' name. Leave them alone in Jesus. Leave the whole church alone. Leave every leader alone. Leave every believer alone, unless the Lord himself tell you to rebuke. Keep your mouth shut. Amen. In Jesus' name. Or you'll give account on the day of judgment, says the Lord. Pride, excitement, selfishness, emotions are rampant in the church today. Worldliness. Show brotherly love. Show humbleness. Hallelujah, disciples of the Lord. Don't you remember when Paul went preaching and Peter went preaching and Jesus told Peter to go, hallelujah, and he was the first apostle until God raised up Paul. And he even said that I'm the least of the apostles, but he was the greatest. You dare say amen? I'm just a nobody. So be careful who you look down on, because God's not looking down on them as far as spiritual, but he is looking down on all of us. But do you remember when Jesus told Peter, let down the net? He said, Lord, not so. I've never ate none of this stuff. He said, go and preach to the Gentiles. He said, hallelujah. He said, go over to Cornelius' house. There's one that need to hear. And he went. After he was rebuked, he went by God. There's a difference. Somebody say there's a difference. There's a difference in being rebuked by God and man. Hallelujah. Some people rebuke me. I say, I'm still standing, sir. I feel nothing. I'm not convicted. Amen. I don't care. I don't care. Amen. You can rebuke me. If it's from the Lord, I receive it. But if it's from man, that's fall to the ground. I'm sorry. I'm for real. I'm for real. I don't care. T.D. Jakes, whoever, rebuke me. I'm not going to do nothing for me. Not unless it's God. Hallelujah. But so he went to preach to Cornelius. What happened? The Holy Ghost fell. And God baptized Cornelius in the Holy Ghost. And what did Peter say? Surely God is no respecter of persons. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But after that mighty act and act, mighty deed, you go over into Hebrews. And there he went back and left the Gentiles and preaching to all. Somebody say all. And then he went back and preaching to Jews only. And Paul had to go and rebuke him and say, listen, enough of this. Amen. In the name of Jesus, preach to everyone. Stop preaching to Jew only. Stop preaching to Christian only. Come on, somebody. Stop preaching to church only. Amen. Hallelujah. Are you there? Say amen. Stop preaching to America only. Stop preaching to Hamlin only. Stop preaching to North Carolina only. Amen. It's more than that. Paul's already rebuked Peter for it. Amen. We don't need to be rebuked anymore. Don't invite me back to another pulpit, hallelujah, or another revival, hallelujah, if you're going to act like you're the only ones. You're the only one that's powerful. You're the only believer that knows all revelation. Let me tell you why. I come peaceably most of the time to all revivals, local, wherever, worldwide. But Samuel, they feared and trembled whenever he came. They said, do you come peaceably? He said, I come peaceably. But Samuel, believe it or not, he could come unpeaceably. He could come unpeaceably. Better watch yourselves. What's with the Elijahs, the one Elijah, another era? Watch me. He's pouring it out on all flesh. Somebody say all. We know that there was Elijah and Elijah. That's at least two. But he told Elijah, I have 7,000 more. I have 7,000 more saved. 1 Corinthians 11 and 1. Be ye followers of me, even as I also am of Christ. Be examples set up in the church by God and not man or robbers. You can't, hallelujah, downplay God's Holy Ghost power and anointing and prophecy and revelation and expect a blessing. You reap what you sow. You better be careful, because I'm here to tell you in Luke 6 and 13, and when it was day, he called unto him his disciples, and of them he chose 12. Somebody say 12. Hallelujah. Who also named apostles: Peter, Andrew, James, John, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James, hallelujah, the other, hallelujah, Simon and Judas. Can we just say Matthews? And don't forget about, hallelujah, Mark, John Baptist, Paul, Jude, and Thaddeus, and Timothy, and Stephen, and Luke, to name a few others. You dare say amen. So there's more than just one. Now, Paul? Just Paul? Just Peter? Just So many others. Just Elijah. Just Moses. Just Moses and Aaron. Come on, somebody in the house of God. Disciples of the Lord. Now receive this quick impartation. I tried to be normal. I can't be normal. I tried. Receive this quick impartation. Disciples of revival. Not just disciples of the Lord, disciples of revival. Now receive this one. Disciples of world revival. How many know there's a difference in revival and world revival? Harvest Army, world revival. Mount Moriah, revival. See, you increase. That's a double portion. Our faces will come to a close in a moment. I recently saw a vision that completed the full vision of what God has started. 1-2. The 1 and the 2. 12. 1-2. You there? The first part, y'all know how America looks like this, and it hooks New York and then Florida, kind of. I saw a line come down years ago. I never understood what this line was until I joined Harvest Army, and God spoke and said, line of fire, line of fire. And I'm a part of the line of fire. I've always been in the fire. If you're not in the fire, you need to get in the fire. You need to get on the fire. The next thing I saw, a line hook. Somebody say hook. Now, what's a hook look like? What's the first letter of Jesus? So you hook them in with what? Who? All right. And then I saw this over America, and it hooked and went up like a U. Somebody say you. 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 You are in revival. You are in the church. You are in Jesus. You are hooked in. You follow it? And the U went up about Michigan, somewhere there. It came down straight, and the other one went over like that. I said, that's a funny looking U. It wasn't a U. The other part continued and shot up over there like the other way. It made a double U for world revival, for worship. You there say amen? For Worldwide Vision Day. So a double U. A double portion, Joel 2, Acts 2, Azusa Street, Line of Fire, California, North Carolina, and all up and down. We the midst, we in the middle. God always deals with the midst and in the middle with us, wherever two or three. Don't take very many, just two or three families, two or three people, two or three churches. I said all that to say this. Before the W completed, and there's a W on every country and every continent standing for world revival all over. All, he's calling all, he's pulling out his spirit on all. He wants all to come to repentance. The U I saw in church. Is that in church? U? And beside you is what? R. You are in the church. You are the church. You are in revival. You are in discipleship. Hallelujah. Another vision that completed all of it was God revealed to me a few years back, maybe 4 or 5, I'm not sure. Does anybody remember this when I saw an R come from heaven and light on fire? What next? Christ or Jesus, the hook. and it lit on fire. And the Lord spoke to me and said, revival, and then I'm coming. Revival, and then I'm coming. So that confirmed a double portion both. There's been so many who have said it and who have, and I'll take it to some churches, I'll take it to some other people, and I'll show them the prophecy. And it's been confirmed two or three times by two or three others. And they'll look at it and say, don't take prophecy lightly, brothers and sisters. I don't care who prophesies. If it's coming to pass, if it's showing fruition, if it's the anointing of God, if it's the Holy Ghost of God, we are disciples of the Lord. Be careful with that. It's not one only. It's not one sister prophesying over there in Alabama, and that's it. It's not about that. It's about Jesus. And if you say it's about Jesus, let it be about Jesus, and Jesus is for all. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to have an altar call for this discipleship of the Lord. Praise God, to receive world discipleship. Hallelujah. Disciple of revival, disciple of world revival, discipleship. Don't never stonewall prophecy. Never resist prophecy. Despise not prophesying. Hallelujah. Especially in the last days. Especially in the last days. We want to speak blessings over everybody listening, everybody watching. In the name of Jesus. Those traveling, we pray for traveling mercies and revival in and out. Hallelujah. Try to be normal today. I tried to have a normal service. Like everybody says, I'm normal. I'm just another preacher. I tried. I can't do it. She did it. To the altar. The altar's open. Thank you. Will there be another? Sure. Come to the altar. Come to discipleship of revival right now. World revival right now. Holy Ghost power right now. Sanctify right now. Purity right now. A higher calling right now. In the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you. Church, for leadership. I thank you for increase. Lord, I pray favor and blessings as the soul prospers, as the ministry prospers, as finances prosper. Oh God, grant it, oh Lord God. Thank you for another same in Jesus' name. Receive it right now. God, thank you for the anointing and favor and blessings. Hallelujah. You are a shade. Get in line with God right now. Get in line. Get in line. I swear. She's your shot. Higher heights and deeper depths. God had said to you, in 3 months, you would do things you never did before. It's already begun. You have saw it, and he's going to complete it. In short order, in Jesus' name, he's spoken, and he has begun. In 3 months, he will never be the same again. Hallelujah, world revival. Hallelujah, discipleship. Hallelujah, disciples of the Lord. Followers of Jesus Christ. Apostleship. And students of the Master. Hallelujah. The greatest of all, the Lord Jesus. Teacher, you need not any man teach you, but man can't teach you these things. Only the Holy Ghost can teach you. If a man don't have the Holy Ghost, we pray more than anything, more than God. world revival more than the God of my soul. World revival is salvation. But more than prophecy or any other mighty deeds or many other mighty acts, we pray that you know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. The most important thing. We pray safe travels for Soldier Bill Stedman and family. Get him home safely, Lord. Thank you for traveling mercies. ABCs of faith. Admit that Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah. Admit that all fall short of the glory of God. Admit you're a sinner. Believe in your heart. Hallelujah, that the Spirit of God raised Jesus from the dead on the third day. The stone is rolled away. Hallelujah. Confess in your heart the Lord Jesus Christ. And you shall be saved, whoever you are, wherever you are. Call on the name of the Lord. Draw them in, Lord. Bring them in. You can't come to the Father unless the Spirit draws you. How can you believe without a preacher? How can they preach? How can they hear without a preacher? How can they preach unless they be sent? If you get saved, if you get born again, if it comes into your heart, if you feel the power, if you feel the drawing, if you feel Him sit in your heart, hallelujah, glory to God, then seek a church, a Bible-believing church, a fiery Holy Ghost church. Hallelujah, with signs and wonders. Seek of water baptism. Read the Bible every day. Every day, devote yourself to devotions of the Lord. Believe all the Bible. Read it from Genesis to Revelation. Hallelujah. Read it again. Read it for all of your life, throughout all of eternity, as the Lord tarries. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. And you will be a disciple of the Lord. The Bible says if you continue in His word, then you are His disciple indeed. But if you stop, the discipleship stops, the learning stops, the training stops. You must keep going. You must be born again. Do not fall away from a Bible. Do not fall out of touch. Hallelujah. Do not fall into the weird acts and the strange acts. Follow the acts of the apostles in the book of Acts. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. Let's sing the song. Church.
This is my church.
I will not receive another spirit.
Receive another spirit.
Another Jesus.
Another Jesus.
Any other message?
Any other message?
Save Jesus Christ.
Save Jesus Christ.
And Him crucified.
And crucified.
Devil, this is our church.
This is our church.
You can't have it.
You can't have it.
Back up.
Back up.
Get out.
Get out.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
We plead the blood.
We plead the blood.
And we belong to Jesus.
We belong to Jesus.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Disciples of the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm almost positive there's been a similar message to this today, and I did it for a reason, to prove I could be normal or try to be normal. Y'all don't wanna hear me. Disciples of the Lord.
You don't want normal?
Glory. Thank God for an abnormal preacher. Give him some praise in the house of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Abnormal is good when it's God. God did this to prove, amen, we are different out here. It's not religion. It's not normal. It's not to be frowned upon. And it's not to be looked down on. Give them some praise. Give them some praise. Give them some praise. Hallelujah. We're not going to be looked down on by anybody. We're not lesser. I'm not James the lesser out here. Amen. I'm not James the greatest either. I'm a nobody pointing to the greatest of all. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's all. That's all. Hallelujah. Glory to God. There is one that has a foot issue. Now, I don't know about this foot issue. I don't know what it's called. But it's twisted. It's twisted. Twisted right foot, twisted to the right, walking like outward. I don't know what their condition is called. Take your hand and twist the foot back and say, get in line in the name of Jesus and you shall be healed. Twist it back straight. Believe. Hallelujah. You say, where is that at, preacher? They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. In my name, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. There's so many things we speak out here. People say, what is that in the Bible? Read your Bibles. Read your Bibles. Hallelujah. You'll know the word when you hear the word. Amen. Praise God. Thank God for all His mighty acts and all His mighty people. Amen. Thank God. Amen. For Harvest Army. The harvest is plenty, the laborers are few. Hallelujah. Thank God He's raising up an army. Thank God for the Abrahamic blessing at Mount Moriah. Thank God. Hallelujah. For He's the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. It's not about me. It's not about you. It's not about us. It's about Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If we really believe that in our heart, we are pure at heart. Blessed are the pure at heart, for they shall see God. Increase of visions, increase of seeing, increase in the name of Jesus. And even more, the Lord says, these grounds, these gifts, His church is not for sale. Hallelujah. The property is not for sale. Hallelujah. The dirt is not for sale. If somebody's trying to do that, they are in serious error in the name of Jesus. Amen. It belongs to Him. He gave His life as a ransom for bloodshed. Hallelujah. You can't. We're blood bought with a price. Amen. And I'm talking about property. I'm talking about land. Amen. Hallelujah. Anybody else? Anything else? I thank God for all of you. One more time, we ask a special blessing. We're going to ask Minister Tay, will you dismiss us in prayer?
Lord, we come to you this morning. Thank you for that we heard the message that's been here this morning. Lord, bring us back at the point of time for the next message. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Amen.
Go in peace. We love you. Tell somebody in here about Jesus, and especially tell somebody out there to come. Amen. We love you. Tell people about Jesus.
Repent of your sins and give your life to Jesus. Paul, you need to repent and stop being religious. You think you high-minded, and many are called, a few are chosen. You've been chosen today to come out of your religious ways in the name of Jesus and gainsaying. Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus, thank you for your sacrifice and restoring the works of Satan. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. What are you talking about burying fossils and dinosaur bones? That happened in the flood, sir. In the name of Jesus, repent of your sins. Stop gainsaying against the preaching and the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus is against you. Be careful. God bless you. Yeah, we want some Arby's, all right. You do too. Don't you eat? You eat? Do you eat? Yeah, I don't, you know. God said, pay tithes, pay tithes. Stop.